billahi minasy syaithanir rajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Our main purposes, our objectives as to why we participated in this symposium is only to lead our people, especially our brother and sister Christian here in Manila, to fully understand the historical and legal rights of the Sultanate of Sulu over North Borneo, what is called now Sabah. And also to let the present administration hear our call for help, because if the present administration is fully believe that we are citizens of the Philippines, it is the duty of the government to help the life and property of its citizen. And I repeat, one of those motives or purposes of our symposium is to understand that we are seeking help from the government regarding our claim, which is not only for the welfare of the heirs, Sultan, and the Muslims, but it is the patrimony of the Filipino people. Thank you.
It's not a reclamation, actually. It's not a claim. We are reclaiming what's ours. It's not a Sabah claim. That's a misnomer. We are reclaiming what we own, Sultan of Sulu.
His father, the late Sultan Punjungan Kiram, the father and administrator of the leased territory of North Borneo, declared nationally that Sabah is the patrimony of the Filipino people. Sabah is the patrimony of the Filipino people. And so with that, the British Consul General in Manila wrote a letter recommending to stop the rendering of the annual rental payment to the heirs by the British North Borneo Company and the British Crown. So that, in that process, the heirs of the Sultan of Sulu filed an interpleader suit, not necessarily referring to the proprietary ownership of the Sultanate, but praying that the British North Borneo Company must restore the privilege of the heirs in receiving that annual rental payment. So after the decision made in 1939, the father of His Royal Highness Sultan Ismail Kiram, the late Sultan Punjungan Kiram, the second Sultan of Sulu, was appointed as administrator of the leased territory.
It is incumbent upon the government to help us, to help the Sultan recover his the Sultanate, recover his territory. So yun po, hopefully we can resolve this in a peaceful manner. The Malaysians are Muslim brothers. They believe in the principles of Islam, that this land does not belong to them. This land belongs to the Sultan of Sulu, therefore this should return. This will return back the territory of this hour.
It is incumbent on this new generation of Christians in this country, the majority in this country, to help rectify that mistake, to help restore, you know, justice to us by helping us prosecute this claim in the international arena and convince the leaders of this country to help us. At the very least, that's the least they can do to rectify, to correct, to cure the pain, the difficulties our people have gone through all these centuries, decades, you know. And so that is the main theme I would address in opening this symposium, that this is not just a pursuit of claim by the Sultanate of Sulu, but by all Filipinos, because we are not citizens of this country. We don't have any plans to get out of this country, to become independent anymore, but this country, the leadership of this country, and the Christian majority must do us justice. Because national unity can never be attained without justice for the Muslims. Unless this government, national government, the majority Christians of this country will do justice to the minority of 10 million Muslims, we'll never have national unity